is John called John the Baptist? He was the person who baptized Jesus. John the Baptist was sent to prepare the way for Jesus to come, and he gave the baptism of repentance. The key was the repentance of sins, testifying about the Son of God and making people believe in the Son Jesus. Everyone who was baptized with John's baptism believed in Jesus Christ and acknowledged the justice of the Word of God. Baptism means washing and anointing. It symbolizes dying to sin with Christ, being born again into a new life through Jesus Christ, and uniting with Christ. However, in this age, people have forgotten the heart of baptism, and they have turned to formality. The pastors sprinkled water on people's heads and said, "In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Spirit, I baptize you." And they lied that Jesus is already inside them. What's more shocking is that there are demons who even teach that they have received the Holy Spirit. Because of those lies, the lay believers worship the pastor because they think there's power in the pastor's hands. They did not know God's will for baptism, but they let people take part in the communion if they were baptized in the form of sprinkling or immersion in water. Moreover, they block people who were not baptized in that way from taking part in the communion. This kind of Christian ceremony went on for the past 2,000 years. When we look at the Bible carefully, John the Baptist had baptized with water to testify that Jesus is the Son of God, but he did not actually believe Jesus. The proof is Luke 7 verse 20. When the men came to him, they said, "John the Baptist has sent us to you to ask, 'Are you the expected one, or do we look for someone else?'" This was after Jesus was baptized by John the Baptist, and after Jesus had healed many people of diseases, afflictions, and evil spirits. He gave sight to the blind, the lame walked, the lepers were cleansed, the deaf heard, the dead were raised up, and many signs and wonders were shown. All of Judea and the surrounding regions had already heard about Jesus at this point. John the Baptist was in prison at that time, and when he heard about Jesus, he sent two of his disciples to Jesus to ask this question. In the end, this showed John the Baptist's spiritual state, that he was not convinced of Jesus Christ being the Son of God. He said that he is not worthy to untie the thong of Jesus' sandal. He said that Jesus is the Lamb who takes away the sin of the world, and that he existed before him, but he did not actually believe Jesus. Carefully think about it. If he believed, he should have taken all of his disciples to Jesus to receive the Word of God. Isn't that true? Then why was this written in the Bible? It was to show that this was not over with back then. This was showing the spiritual state of almost all Christians of the world in this age. Then, who takes offense and stumbles because of Jesus' name? John the Baptist sent two of his disciples to Jesus to see if he is indeed the Christ who was prophesied of in the Old Testament. But Jesus did not answer them directly by saying, "I am he." He instead said, "Blessed is he who does not take offense at me." Taking offense means to stumble. People stumble when they do not walk in faith or when they disobey the word. In the end, there was a tremendous secret in the expression "taking offense" about what will happen after Jesus was resurrected and taken up to heaven. By saying that he who does not take offense at Jesus Christ is blessed, it means that there are people who do take offense at Jesus. In other words, it says in Romans 9 verse 33, "I lay in Zion a stone of stumbling and a rock of offense, and he who believes in him will not be disappointed." This means that Jesus has become a stone of stumbling and a rock of offense. This was the truth. Jesus had performed many signs and wonders by healing the sick, casting out demons, raising Lazarus who was dead for 4 days, and raising the crippled. People who followed only the signs and imitated Jesus by trying to perform signs and miracles themselves, they have stumbled in Jesus' name. What is the outcome of taking offense at Jesus? Eternal punishment in hell. The preachers who distort the Bible into worldly words are spiritually murdering the souls of the congregation while they are physically alive. So they are already at the gate of Hades while being alive. And when they die, they will fall to Hades, the eternal hell, but God says that they do not know that. However, God has already given us the way to get out of our stumbled state, as He warned us about the outcome in Mark 9, verse 42 to 49. Whoever causes one of these little ones who believe to stumble, it would be better for him if with a heavy millstone hung around his neck, he had been cast into the sea. If your hand causes you to stumble, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life crippled than having your two hands to go into hell, into the unquenchable fire. Once you go to eternal punishment in hell, you cannot go back. The right eye and right hand mean the leader who speaks lies different from the Bible in Jesus' name. Cutting them off means to leave that church that is a home for demons. That is why Jesus Christ said that it is to our advantage that He goes away, and He promised to send the another helper, the Spirit of Truth, in John 16, verse 7. He made this promise because the role of the another helper, the Spirit of Truth, is to come to this earth and restore and guide into all the truth. The Spirit of Truth, Reverend Okjushin, has been carrying out the perfect biblical reformation with the new covenant. That is the everlasting covenant that fulfills the word, "Blessed is he who does not take offense at me." The truth will always come true in reality. Grace World Podcast full audio version available at Podbean and Apple Podcasts.